Hello fellow astrophotographers and welcome back to our channel. Firstly, let me wish you Happy New Year. I hope you had a nice Christmas holidays. In today's video, we'll be comparing the two new telescopes of the WO Optics lineup, the RedCat 91 and the MiniCat 51. Now, we have already tested the MiniCat 51 while shooting the Comet Atlas A3. I have put the link to that video in the description. But during the Christmas holidays, we also decided to do a proper first light test on deep sky objects. And just in time for that test, we have also received the new RedCat 91, so we decided to test them side by side and see how they compare optically. Now, of course, because the MiniCat 51 has focal ratio of f3.5, it has some aberrations in the corners. This is also advertised by WO Optics, and they even recommend using tools such as BlurXTerminator to fix the stars. In contrast, here we have the RedCat 91, which is advertised as optically one of the best telescopes of WO Optics lineup. So I think they form a great pair to test side by side and see how they perform. Just a quick disclaimer, we did not have two identical cameras to test them in same conditions during same nights, but rather we swapped the camera from one telescope to the other and tried to image in similar conditions. We did have about 2 weeks of nice clear sky in December, which is quite rare here, so we managed to capture 3 targets with both telescopes to compare how they perform. Now, before we get into the comparison, let's first check out a quick unboxing video of the RedCat 91. What a beast! That's the biggest refractor telescope I ever had, so it's gonna be fun to test. And the massive dowtail I see, that's kind of a hybrid between Losmandy and Vixen. Never seen such a dowtail before. Integrated autofocuser, integrated focuser, like with all new WO Optics reflectors. Massive aperture, at least for my standards of refractors. And at the back, manual field rotator, M48. But this one I think doesn't have any tilt adjustment, if I'm not mistaken. M48 thread can be replaced with the M54 thread plate, so you can attach the larger cameras or field rotators at the back. After unboxing, it was time for some imaging, but before we could run the setups, we had to solve the autofocusing. Both telescopes are compatible with ZWO electronic autofocuser, but we also wanted a simple grab-and-go solution, similar to our flap panels, so we are able to attach the motor with least hassle possible. That is why we developed a simple bracket that fits onto the ring of the RedCats and is attached with two simple hand-tightening knobs. To demonstrate this better, here are two short clips of attaching flap panel and autofocuser to MiniCat 51 and RedCat 91. We'll be right back. After both telescopes were ready, it was time to do some imaging. We have chosen three photogenic winter sky targets: Andromeda Galaxy, Pleiades and Ruff's Cave Nebula. We used Player 1 Poseidon C camera with APS-C format sensor. After we gathered a few nights of data on each target with both telescopes and shot calibration frames, it was time for aberration inspection. For this purpose, let's check out star field around Pleiades, where we have plenty of stars to see how the corners look. First, let's check out corners of both images without BlurXTerminator. Just stacked data and screen transfer function applied. As we can see, corners of RedCat 91 are much better. But I must say, I am surprised in a positive way by the MiniCat 51 optics. I honestly expected much worse corners, considering this is f3.5 refractor. Now let's check out both fields after BlurXTerminator. We can see biggest improvement on the MiniCat 51 image, where stars are much improved and look decent. This little refractor will surely come in handy to gather some wide field data of dim targets quicker. After we post-processed all three targets, we decided to create a composite high resolution images by upscaling the MiniCat 51 images and superimposing them with RedCat 91 data. And in case of Andromeda Galaxy, we also incorporated the RC close-up data at 1600mm of focal length with an H-alpha signal for additional details. This close-up was a collaboration effort with our good friend from Canada, Tudor Chibacu. We've included a link to his Instagram account in the video description. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the video and it can be helpful if you're considering purchasing either of these two telescopes. If you have any additional questions regarding the telescopes, post-processing or other equipment, do not hesitate to comment below. Now to finish this video off, let's check out the zoom out animation of finished images of all three targets we shot. Stay tuned and as always, clear skies.